The U.S. greatly appreciates their efforts and transparency. It will all work out well, in particular on behalf of the American people. I want to thank President Xi. Yeah. And take a listen to these two snippets of President Sure. Trump in February and March.
I think President Xi is working very, very hard. I spoke to him. He's working very hard. I think he's doing a very good job.
I have great respect for President Xi. I consider him to be a friend of mine. It's unfortunate that this got out of control. It came from China. It got out of control. Some people are upset.
So obviously the details are different, but how can you criticize the World Health Organization for doing the same thing President Trump did, believing President Xi?
See, here's the thing, Jake. One of the reasons why the president may have said that is because he trusted the World Health Organization to be telling him the truth as well. That was a conspiracy between China and the client in the World Health Organization. One of the things I'd love to see CNN do is a special on Tedros. I mean, that's a bad, bad man. I mean, he was implicated in scandals and cholera in his home country, and that country itself. Do a feature on that. How much money does China give to its client state of Ethiopia so that it's become a client? I think the problem, the old expression, I hate to mention this guy, Dukakis, but he always talking about the fish rotting from the head down. That's the problem at the World Health Organization. The leadership there, we're giving them $500 million a year, and what did they give us back? A global pandemic with secrecy, working with communist China on this. I mean,
So you're saying President Trump made the mistake of listening not only to President Xi, but to the World Health Organization.
I never love it when people rephrase me, but let's just put it on the table. The Chinese came here on January 15th to sign a trade deal. That might have been a nice time to let us know that there was a raging pandemic with human-to-human transmission. Instead, the day before, the World Health Organization put a tweet out that said, "Nope."
Well, the Taiwanese were warning the Taiwanese were warning 2 weeks, I think, before that trade deal. But Peter Navarro, thank you so much. And Peter, you would be interested to know, listen to this next promo I'm about to tell you. Be sure to tune in this Sunday. CNN's Fareed Zakaria will investigate the moment the pandemic was born. The CNN special report, China's Deadly Secret, airs Sunday night at 9, and I know Peter Navarro will be watching. You should as well. Coming up next, the stunning number of groceries.